And I have to begin by saying 250 million Americans are not garbage. This week, Kamala has been comparing her political opponents to the most evil mass murderers in history. And now, speaking on a call for her campaign last night, crooked Joe Biden finally said what he and Kamala really think of our supporters. He called them garbage. No way. No way! And they actually mean it, even though without question, my supporters are far higher quality than Crooked Joe or Lion Kamala. Higher quality. Higher quality. My response to Joe and Kamala is very simple. You can't lead America if you don't love Americans. That's true. You can't be president if you hate the American people, which I believe they do.
Who would have ever thought that French fries and garbage could potentially win the presidential election? If you had that on your bingo card, let me know down below. But just an absolutely stunning turn of events. And just to show you the impact that this is having, take a look at the Google Trends. So this blue line is the Google search volume, the intensity on a scale from 0 to 100. You can see the blue line is the Puerto Rico garbage comment. It peaks a little above 20%, but, you know, this is manufactured outrage from the media, so it's not really gaining much traction. But this red line is the search volume, the search intensity, what people want to know about Joe Biden calling Trump supporters garbage. And you can see it peaked immediately at 100% intensity, search volume, and you can see that red line, Joe Biden's comments, completely dominating, completely taking air away from all other conversations. This is what everyone is talking about right now. And, you know, a lot of people were upset about the comedian making the Puerto Rico trash comment. But, you know, the Lord works in mysterious ways. And who would have ever thought that the silver lining that was there has come to fruition? And Trump is using this to his advantage. And he certainly is the king of the troll. I think his next book, if he writes another book, you know, he wrote The Art of the Deal. He should write a book called The Art of the Troll. That would be brilliant. So this is how this whole ordeal went down. Trump got off of his plane, Trump Force One. By the way, if you want to know the inside story of how his team and Trump decided to put on the vest, decided to get the garbage truck with the Trump logo on it, I have Trump telling that story, and that will be the last clip I play later in the video. It is actually really hilarious, and it's an interesting inside look into the campaign and how they work so fast, so last minute, and how these ideas are just tossed around and how they respond to events in real time. But, you know, Trump got off Trump Force One with the orange vest. He went into the garbage truck. He held a mini press conference there. Then he headed to this rally in Green Bay, Wisconsin. So as I just referenced, he gave a mini press conference from within the truck. And this is what he said to reporters.
How do you like my garbage truck? This truck is in honor of Kamala and Joe Biden.
Just absolutely great. And my favorite part of all of this is that Republicans are rallying around Trump. It wasn't just Trump. Vivek Ramaswamy actually did a mini garbage route. He actually loaded the garbage himself and helped with the disposal process.
All right. Let's do it, man. I got it.
You got it?
Yeah. Tell me, what are we doing here?
Right up to the lift.
Okay. Right up to here.
Yep. Come up. Turn around. Pretty much right there. Always lift the lid open.
Wait, is it on?
Yeah.
All right, sweet. Lift open. And then what are we doing?
Pull them both out.
Pull them both out. Doing it right? Pull this one back too, or you're good?
Yeah, you're good right now.
Sweet.
Wait for it to go all the way up.
Pretty good machinery, actually. It kind of works. Should I pull it back again?
No, just pull. This goes up.
Should I pull it?
Yeah, pull it out.
Pull it out?
Yeah.
I've never. This is cool. I mean, obviously, I see right, the man. Garbage truck
Let's do it.
Go by, but I've never seen how it actually works.
It's pretty good. Yes. The machine is good. It's good machine.
Yeah, Vivek actually getting his hands dirty, actually doing the thing. And what this shows you is how Republicans right now are really circling the wagons. Everyone is on the same page. I mean, how could you not just... completely offensive for Joe Biden to call half of America garbage. And by the way, where's Kamala Harris being pressed on this? She is his vice president. She said she would do nothing differently from him. She said that they are on the same page. So if Joe Biden calls half of America garbage, does that not by extension and based on Kamala's own statements, does that not imply and suggest that she believes the same thing? She should be asked about this. The media should be asking her. Now, the way you know that Trump... is really freaking Democrats out right now is based on how the mainstream media is responding. So over on CBS, Nora O'Donnell was complaining that Republicans and Trump allies aren't giving any grace to Joe Biden's garbage comments.
We're now 6 days out from Election Day. Nearly 60 million votes have already been cast in early in-person voting and through the mail. And the latest polls suggest the race could not be tighter. Both campaigns are locking their focus on the battleground states. Vice President Kamala Harris...
I'm going to pause here. By the way, there are reports that the Harris campaign has withdrawn their resources from North Carolina. Now, it doesn't sound like they've withdrawn all of them, but it sounds like they're really refocusing on Virginia and New Mexico. So to me, that suggests that maybe they're conceding early. I get, you know, Election Day isn't here. But if you're pulling resources out of North Carolina, that suggests that you're either very confident in your ability to win it or you're saying, hey, this isn't looking good. We need to protect other areas.
Rallied in North Carolina and Pennsylvania today and is in Wisconsin tonight. Former President Donald Trump was in North Carolina earlier and tonight is also in Wisconsin. He landed in Green Bay just a short time ago and then pulled this campaign stunt, speaking to reporters from a garbage truck. Proof that he and his supporters are giving no grace to a gaffe by President Biden, where he, in his explanation, inadvertently called Trump supporters garbage. This, of course, was in response to that racist joke about floating garbage told at a Trump rally.
She's complaining that no one is giving grace to Joe Biden for calling half of America garbage, and then she herself gives zero grace to a comedian. By the way, he wasn't one of the main speakers, Tony Hinchcliffe. If you actually look at the campaign rally schedule for that day at Madison Square Garden, he was a warm-up act for the warm-up acts. He wasn't even one of the key speakers. So, and again, he's a comedian. He's not running for office. So the left gave zero grace to them, and now they're complaining that the right is giving zero grace to Joe Biden's comments. Now, I do want to analyze Joe Biden's comments because the White House and Democrats have come up with the most unreal, stupefying explanation to defend what Joe Biden said. So for those of you who have been following the channel for a while, you know that I am both a professional actor and a professional musician, and that's how I want to analyze Joe Biden's comment, because it will really expose just how dumb the Democrats think we are, which I think is really insulting, because their defense, their explanation for Joe Biden's comment is really ridiculous. So from the acting perspective, let's talk about Joe Biden's cadence when he said this statement. You heard me pause right there. Usually you pause when you finish a thought. There's usually a pause when you finish a complete sentence. Similarly, from the musical perspective, you can think about the pitch of your voice. It goes up, it goes down, it goes up, it goes down. Usually when you finish a thought, when you finish a sentence, there is a very clear, my voice goes down. When you're in the middle of a sentence and there's more to be said, the pitch tends to be higher. So you can usually tell, so two things, the cadence, and then you can follow the pitch of his voice. So I want you to listen to Joe Biden's comments through that lens.
Or Puerto Rico, where I'm in my home state of Delaware, they're good, decent, honorable people. The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters. His demonization is seen as unconscionable, and it's un-American.
So if you listen to that, if you just listen to the cadence of it, there was a very clear pause after his supporters because he just finished a complete statement. He finished a complete thought, a complete sentence. And actually, the pitch in his voice stayed pretty constant. There was no indication. It never went up. There was no sign that he had more to say to finish that train of thought. He made a complete argument, then completely went on. I think anyone honestly listening to that would, you know, agree. Let's just listen one more time.
Or Puerto Rico, where I'm in my home state of Delaware, they're good, decent, honorable people. The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters. His demonization is seen as unconscionable. And
so
it's un-American.
The Washington Post put out three different ways you could transcribe what Joe Biden said. Way number one, I believe, is the honest way. So here is what I believe was actually said. The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters, period. His demonization of Latinos is unconscionable and it's un-American. I believe this is the accurate way to transcribe this. However, the Washington Post did put out two alternatives. The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters, S', suggesting that there's more to be said there. His supporters' rhetoric, his supporters' arguments. So really trashing, you know, Trump voters. Or option number two is his supporters, S', maybe referring specifically to Tony Hinchcliffe. But it, again, if you listen to his cadence, if you listen to the pitch in his voice, there is absolutely no indication that he was going to continue the train of thought talking about supporters. Well, what does the official White House transcript say? As you can probably guess, the White House official transcript, what's going to go down in the history books, isn't actually what Joe Biden said. Newsweek is even reporting on this. Joe Biden's transcript of, quote, garbage remarks raises eyebrows. Here is what the White House put out. They used his supporters, S'. This is the White House official transcript of Biden's comments. This is what's going to go down in the history books. Now, we should not be surprised. This is the same administration. This is the same group. This is the same ecosystem that has been covering up for Joe Biden's cognitive decline over the last few years. This is the same group that's been covering up for the ethics complaints and investigations into the Bidens. You know, the IRS whistleblowers weren't able to speak out against the Bidens, and obviously the DOJ special counsel Robert Hur decided not to pursue charges against the Bidens, decided not to pursue further investigation because, you know, he was just a well-meaning elderly old man with a poor memory. But the way you know this is really bothering Democrats, the way you know that Trump is right over the target, right over the bullseye, again, is based on how the mainstream media is reacting. Just take a look at Morning Joe. They freaked out on MSNBC this morning.
The hypocrisy, Mika, over a misstatement by Joe Biden, which he quickly corrected, is so laughable because this guy does this every day. And then you turn on Fox News and say, oh, how could anybody do this? I've never seen this before from a press. Despite the fact one of the people saying that yesterday on Fox News stood by while Donald Trump watched violence erupt on January the 6th and kept allowing violence to erupt on January the 6th and said the people that were beating the hell out of cops.
Trump wanted the National Guard.
So yes,
it was Pelosi and Mayor Bowser that prevented it.
Willie, the gaslighting never ends. They really do think that their voters are that stupid. And it makes me sad for those voters that Donald Trump and people on TV, on other channels, really think Americans are that dumb.
Yeah, and let's not forget Donald Trump has spent the last couple of weeks calling the entire country a garbage can.
What is sad is that people actually believe that, you know, people who watch MSNBC, more people watch MSNBC, by the way, than watch CNN. It's really terrifying, really scary. Speaking of CNN, my favorite part of this whole thing was Wolf Blitzer was on the air. He had guests on, and they interrupted his program with a breaking news alert, and it was Trump in the garbage truck. This was probably my favorite moment of the whole night.
Interrupt you for a moment. Stand by for a moment. Trump is answering some questions from reporters.
Joe Biden to make that statement, it's really a disgrace.
You know that got to have hurt Wolf Blitzer just a little bit on the inside. Just, oh, ouch. Now, the early voting data does look good. I went over that yesterday, but do not take anything for granted. Pretend like we're 10 points behind and your vote is the deciding vote. I do want to be fair and balanced, and Charlie Kirk is putting out a warning, according to Charlie Kirk, Early votes has been disproportionately female. If men stay at home, Kamala is president. It's that simple. If you want a vision of the future, if you don't vote, imagine Kamala's voice cackling forever. Men need to go vote now. And indeed, the early voting... Newsweek, women dominate early voting as Donald Trump supporters get nervous. If we take a look at the statistics, it is 54% women who have voted early compared to just 44% men. That is 98% of the populace. I don't know what the other 2% are. I can just imagine they use other pronouns. Well, Jake Paul has come out and endorsed Trump, and I'm assuming this is... in an attempt to get more young men to vote, Jake Paul put out an 18-minute video on who he is supporting for president and why you should support Trump as well. And Caitlyn Jenner actually responded, "Well said, Jake Paul. Thank you for joining in, speaking out so candidly and powerfully." Now, so you have people like Jake Paul putting out really thoughtful endorsements, getting high praise on social media, and then you have Mark Cuban calling into The View and saying this.
Donald Trump, you never see him around strong, intelligent women, ever. It's just that simple.
Kellyanne Conway, strong, intelligent woman. One of his campaign managers, there are two, if I recall correctly, but one of them is Susie Wiles. What about her? Sarah Huckabee Sanders. I mean, he has had strong women around him throughout this entire time, throughout his entire political career. So I don't know what Mark Cuban is actually getting to there. And by the way, strong women, strong, intelligent women. I know I have a lot of women watching. If you are a strong, intelligent woman voting for Trump, let me know in the comments down below. Let me know whether or not you are offended by Mark Cuban's comments. Now, as I teased earlier in the video, at the rally in Green Bay, Wisconsin, Donald Trump gave the inside story. He gave the inside scoop on how this garbage truck stunt and how the orange vest came to be, and it is hilarious. Just to give you a heads up, this is a 4-minute clip, but I've edited out just all the audience cheers, but Trump is... He was on fire. He was a 10 out of 10. It was hilarious. And this is the side of Trump that the media never shows you, because this right here could be a Netflix comedy special.
So this outfit, you know, is when he called us all garbage. How stupid. What a stupid word. That blows deplorable away, don't you think? Of course, I thought irredeemable when she said deplorable or irredeemable. I thought irredeemable was actually worse, but deplorable seemed to catch up. But this garbage stuff blows it away. So I'm in this beautiful plane. I'm enjoying myself. I have a wonderful suit on. And one of my people came in and said, "Sir, you know, the word garbage is the hottest thing right now out there. The hottest thing out there, sir. Would you like to drive a garbage truck?" Now, we're about, you know, 30 minutes from landing. We had to do this pretty quick. I said, "It's sort of cool, though, isn't it? Because, you know." And I said, "You know, I think that's okay. But, you know, I don't feel comfortable wearing a suit." And they pulled up this garbage truck. I don't know how the hell they did it so fast. I have very capable people. They put a big sign on the truck. Did you see it? I think they showed it to you. And then they said, "Sir, we have a vest." I said, "Well, should I leave my suit on and put it over the vest? But that doesn't look very good, right? That doesn't look good." So I said, "All right, look, let me take it off." And then I actually said, I climbed into the truck, but here's the, so I said, "How the hell do you get into this truck? It's way up high. It's a big one." This was a beauty. I said, "You didn't have to buy it that big, right? You have to get it that big." They brought this brand new, gorgeous truck, wonderful driver. He looked like Cary Grant in his prime. You know who that is?
I don't know who that is. Should I?
And he drove that big thing up. And I said, "Man, this is bad, because now I have all the cameras are all watching. Look at all the fake news." They were, most of them, many of them were there. And I'm saying, "Oh, boy. You know, one little mistake with these guys and your political career is over. You can't even..." So I said, "Man, if I don't get up there, this is going to be very embarrassing." These stupid people, they'll say, "He's cognitively and physically impaired." And I can't do that when I'm alongside of this great athlete. I got to get up to that. So the stair, the first stair is like up here. I'm saying, shit. So So I had the adrenaline going and I made it. And then I gave a little news conference from the front of the, you know, they asked their wise guy questions and everything. And then we drove about 2 feet. I got out, got into the plane. And then I got in the car and I'm driving over here and I have this still on. And I come into the arena and I say, where's my jacket? I want to get out of this thing. And they said, it would be unbelievable if you could wear it on stage. I said, and I said, no way. I got 25,000 people standing outside. I got all these people here. There's no way I'm wearing it on stage. They said, oh, okay, sir. I said, get me my jacket. But if you did, you know, it actually makes you look thinner. I said, and they got me. I said, I want to wear it on stage. When they said I look thinner, I said, in that case, I'll wear it on stage. I may never wear a blue jacket again. I may go in this. I said that. That was the word. That was the key. Sir, you look thinner. So anyway, so we had a little fun about a very serious subject. We had a little fun about a time where our country is not having a lot of fun because we're not doing well as a country, but we're going to be doing well very shortly. I promise you that.
I mean, just an absolutely pitch perfect speech. I mean, he hit every nail. The comedic timing was awesome. And then at the very end, obviously bringing it in to the serious topics we're talking about today, being relatable to every single American, making sure that all Americans know that he is working for them, representing them, wants to fight for them. I thought, what an incredible way to close out this final stretch of the election. And we still have a few more days. What is going to happen? I know there's going to be more. This is truly exciting. As always, though, this is just my analysis, just my commentary. This is what's going on in the world of politics from my point of view. And I would love to hear from you. What do you think about this whole garbage spectacle? Were you expecting it to backfire as big as it did? Did you know it would be this big? Or is it even exceeding your expectations? I think when Joe Biden said it, you know, obviously social media was on fire, but I didn't realize that it would suck that much oxygen out of the room. I didn't realize that this controversy would spread like wildfire. And then on top of that, for the Trump campaign to seize on this moment, it's not just the fact that Joe Biden said that, you know, there was already a fire. And by seizing on the moment the way Trump did, they threw gasoline on the fire and it is now a troll of epic proportions. But most importantly, it's not just a troll. It's actually speaking directly to the voters. And I think it will have a huge impact. And I want to hear about how you've been experiencing it. How did you find out about this whole controversy? Are people talking about it in your family, in the workplace, at school? You know, it's been dominating the conversation online, but online isn't necessarily real life. So I'd love to get the on-the-ground accounts from all of you and see what real-world impact this story is having. For those of you new to the channel, my goal is to reach 100,000 subscribers. If and when the channel is lucky enough to get there, we will celebrate all of you. And then I will also introduce my dog as well as my cat who made an appearance earlier. Tell you their names, their adoption stories. No one yet has guessed accurately. I'm going through all the comments, and there have been some great guesses, but none yet. Also, two different live stream notes. Number one, more long term. One of you asked this question yesterday, and I didn't respond, but I'm responding now. And I'm sorry because I lost track of the comment. But I do still plan on live streaming Christmas carols and piano music sometime in December. So as I referenced earlier, I am a professional pianist, and for the channel, it's probably going to be a 2 or 3 hour stream, and I will just be taking requests during that stream. So think of your favorite Christmas songs. Let me know. I know I've gotten a few already. Silent Night, White Christmas, a few of the classics, Silver Bells. But just keep brainstorming those and let me know. You know, you can let me know in the comments or during the live stream, and I'll try to get as many requests in as possible. But more short term and more immediately, next week is the election, and I do plan on live streaming election night. I'm trying to work out the details, including the start time. So I will let you all know as soon as those details are hammered away. Now, if you love watching, you know, Fox News, CNN, MSNBC, I'm not saying, you know, to drop your election night plans and watch the channel. But if you weren't planning on doing something and you want to join, let's stream together. It'll be fun. Personally, I love CNN's election night coverage, mostly because of the soundtrack. I think it is banger. So I'll probably have them going on so I can hear the music in the headphones. I think it's just electric. But I will definitely be here and will hopefully be celebrating with all of y'all. If you haven't already, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. I know it's a simple thing to ask for, but it really does help me in the algorithm to reach more viewers like you. Be sure to smash that subscribe button and to check out one of these videos.